G'day, this is Tim from Nortronics. Today I'm doing an assembly to fit my little motors so that they basically will sit on this bracket, on the back of that, through the shaft and onto the gear. And because I need to bolt it all together, I want to go through and put these insert nuts into each of the pieces so that I can screw a standard screw into these countersunk holes. And it will hold together nice and securely. So the way I do this is I have these, I think they're called melt set nuts. So these are M3 type. And all I do is choose a appropriate soldering iron tip. And I tend to go for, I think it's this one here, because it sits quite nicely on it. It doesn't slide down too far and it's easier to get it off. It doesn't get stuck. Or some of the others, let's see which one. Some of them will fit on too nicely, but it actually gets stuck. But, anyway, so we're going to use this one here. So what I'll do is I'll put that onto my iron, replacing the current tip. And I'm going to set my iron's temperature a little bit lower than what I usually have it. So my normal soldering temperature is 250 degrees. So what I'm going to do is lower that down to about 150. And that's just so the plastic doesn't melt as quick as it would otherwise. So it's overshot that temperature a bit, so it's going to come back down. All right, so the way I approach this is I'll just work out which direction I need. So these motors will sit with a bracket that holds it flush to the front like so. So I need the melt sets in there and two in there. A pair of pliers comes in very handy here. And all we do is we stick that on there and we basically line it up with a hole, and it doesn't really matter if you go a little bit crooked because it does melt and allow you to move it around. And just applying a light amount of pressure, it will start to melt into it. So go down till it's deep enough. Should be flush off with the front. That one's reasonably straight. Now the holes here, when I've 3D printed these parts, I've set the hole at, I think it was 3 millimeters. The outer diameter of these is about 4.5 millimeters, and that gives it enough room for the plastic to melt and push around and still get a nice secure grip. So we'll do another one. So that one's slightly crooked, so all I do is just bend it again. Still not quite right, it's not quite in far enough. Okay, so we just go through and do that for each of them. We won't make you watch through the whole video of me doing that. We'll fast forward. Okay, so now that I've done that, we've got them all firmly set in so they won't come out. And just using my M3-8 screws, so yeah, they'll screw in quite nicely and you've got a very secure fitting part. So I'll go through and I'll assemble my brackets onto the back plane there. And there we have it. So basically that motor will fit through the shaft on here, get in the right spot, and there is my motor drive, and it'll be the same on this side, and we're ready to go. So after we've done all the assembly, we've got the motors neatly bolted in, they're secure, and all I have to do is put on the gears with the index in the right spot. There we go. And the other one. And those gears will be clamped down on the front so they won't be able to slide. So clamp down there with another bracket the same. So basically that will clamp onto there, holding everything in place so the gears can't slip. And that is my motor assembly.